Okay, so we just arrived at Roland Garros. We're at the side of the four musketeers with Tecnifibre's Guillaume Ducruet, and he's going to take us around and explain who the four musketeers are and a little bit about the area.
Okay, so actually, the four musketeers are the first best French champion in the beginning of the 20th century. Actually, this stadium, the Roland Garros stadium, have been built for the first Davis Cup. So obviously the four musketeers won the Davis Cup many times against Australia, America, and England. And to welcome the Davis Cup, the French government and the French Federation built this stadium. That's why now the four musketeers are here just to be dedicated for the guys.
Okay, let's go ahead and have a look at the statues.
Okay, it's Jean Borotra. Jean Borotra belongs to the French team, okay? Okay, he's dying now, like the other players. Jean came from the Pays Basque, in the southwest of France, and his nickname was the Basque bondissant. It means the Basque who jump every time, you know? So, because his kind of play was very... actually, the opponent didn't know what happens, because he was very... he played in the net, he stayed in the baseline, he was very...
very crafty.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. It okay. was a very, at this time, in the beginning of the century, it was very new for the tennis, actually. Okay. That's why it's a Basque bondissant.
Okay, so we're at the next statue now, and this player is Henri Cochet.
Henri Cochet, yes. Okay, Henri Cochet just, it's been number one in the world. He belongs to the French team as well. If I remember well, I think he's come from Lyon or this Rhône-Alpes area, the southeast of France. He was a very efficient player, very good player. He fought a lot with some player from England, from Fred Perry. Mm-hmm. And that's a very, very good player as well.
Probably more known, especially in America, statues. Can you explain this one?
Okay, here? So very easily. It's René Lacoste. Again, René Lacoste belongs to the French team. And he's the owner of the Lacoste company that everybody knows. And his nickname was the Crocodile. While the Crocodile was his nickname, and the same because the Crocodile is the logotype of the clothes company, it's because in French, we call the Crocodile the guy in tennis. It's like a pusher, you know? A Crocodile, like the animals, who is waiting for the prey, mm-hmm. and very take a long time in the water, and very patient, and when the pro is coming, up, catch it very easily. That's why we call the Crocodile, because René Lacoste stayed a long time at the baseline and waiting for the fault of the opponent. That's why it's called the Crocodile.
Okay.
And now the Crocodile stayed, and you can see the Crocodile on the shirt, on the socks, and on the caps, shoes, mm-hmm. everywhere. That's the brand of the Lacoste company. That's brand that Andy Roddick used.
Okay, right. Okay, so we're at the final of the four musketeers right here. Would you like to explain this player, Guillaume?
Actually, it was the last guy for the French team, Jacques Brugnon, sorry, was probably the best double player. He was very useful for the team, for the double, in Davis Cup, obviously. Still now, double is very important. So mm-hmm. that is the team, double was very important, and Jacques was a very good player. He won so many times the French Open in the mixed double and the men's double. And he was very efficient in this kind of play. He was a very good player in double.
Okay, so we're right outside the main stadium right here, and there's a big screen up there which shows all the on-court action. Unfortunately, it's raining right now, so I'm going to try and...
First time in France.
Yeah, first time it rains at the French Open. I'm going to try and dissuade the rain. I'm going to put my sunglasses on. Hopefully the sun will come out and we'll get some more tennis on today. We're in one of the indoor centers at Roland Garros, and this is kind of like a fun area where the public can come in and check things out. Over here, we've got kind of urban tennis, so they've set up kind of a street scene where people can play tennis out on the court. They got the hip-hop music going. Then over on the far side, there's an Adidas-sponsored section where people can hang out. There's TVs going so they can see, you know, the on-court action. They can also just kind of watch music videos and stuff. Let's head on over to this side now. Back over there on the far side is an autograph area. So when pros come in, they'll do autograph signing sessions over there. And then right here we have a PlayStation area. So you can come in, play some PlayStation games. Great thing to do when it's raining or you want to take a break between matches. And then over here, what's really cool at the French Open is the stringing service, the Tecnifibre stringing service is open. It's completely open and visual to the public. So the public can come in, they see all the pros' rackets getting strung, stringers working. Obviously, it's the beginning of the tournament, so the guys are working really hard right now to get everyone's rackets strung and ready for practice and for match play.